Greetings, sir and sirettes, and welcome back to Fallout 4 with me, Lathrix, and of course, welcome back to the castle. As I promised, today is going to be a day of building. No more combat, no more searching out for side quests or the main quests. We are going to be focusing on what is truly important in this game, building up our settlements and growing our little legion of followers. The glorious settlers that make Fallout the beautiful place it is. And as a result, we're actually not going to be building here. A bit of a weirdness indeed, but we're not going to be building in the castle today. We are going to be building over there on the island, as I have it on good knowledge, on good information, that location over there is actually buildable on and can be a settlement. The only problem I have is, can you actually ferry goods automatically and put it into the trade route, considering it is literally an island completely separated from the mainland, and we seemingly have no access to boats. He is hoping you can, so I'm going to swim over and see just if it is actually true that this place is buildable upon. So let me see. Hazmat suit is on. That way we won't sink to the bottom of the water using the power suit. And let's get going. But before we do, I would like to say that I do now have a huge reserve of both steel, wood, and every other possible building material, which of course, as always, I've procured in a very peaceful and friendly manner. Because Curie is also completely peaceful and friendly.
Perfect.
I wonder, have they hired a visual contact more dangerous? Combat is quite vigorous exercise.
Welcome to Spectacle Island, the island of mist, dead settlers, and Mirelurks. Lots and lots of Mirelurks. But thankfully, also the island of loot, honestly. There have been loads of things like safes in this locale over here, loads of little chests hidden around. It's been quite the experience, which isn't what I was expecting. I wasn't expecting on going on a bit of a journey when I wanted to build here, but apparently that's what Fallout wants me to do. So we continue our hunt, though. Oh, hello. For the workbench, I was about to say, but here's yet another Mirelurk. Face the wrath of recently upgraded gun. It now has the most armor-piercing this gun can possibly get. Of course, the gun itself is still pretty darn terrible, so even with the armor-piercing, it's not fantastic. But it's better than nothing. It also means I don't mind aiming at this thing's shell. I think I just heard another one as well. There we go. It doesn't help that I don't know the weak spot of that thing. I know you, it's the head. I'm slightly too fast for it, that was kind of sad. Oh! What the hell are you? What on earth are you? I don't have the Fat Man anymore, I have no ammo for it. Kill the Mirelurk, then focus on whatever that thing was. That looks something out of a H.M. Lovecraft book. Legendary Mirelurk Deep King. Kind of looks like a Murloc from Warcraft. Almost. How about laser weapons? Oh yeah, that seems to be going okay. That's it, Curie. Just keep tanking the hits. I believe you. Nope, never mind. You've just been knocked out. Of course it mutated. I mean, why wouldn't it? Oops, shotguns seem to be doing a lot better, though. Maybe lasers aren't very good against it. And that was just a better weapon. Is it shooting sound at me? Wow, that's creepy. That's... I mean... It's okay. Actually, the base stats are okay. It's not amazing, though. That's a very satisfying shot. Okay, back to what we were doing. Well defended little shack. I'm hoping there's something special about this. Oh, The workbench. Workshop, rather. Why can't I use the workshop? Oh, hello. Oh. Okay. Make sure the wires to the generator are all connected properly. And then the generator must be on before turning on the signal tower. Okay. I suggest you stay out of the water when flipping the generator switch. Just saying. You'll know when the signal is playing when... Well, you'll just know. Once the feedback goes away, it should sound like there's nothing coming out the speakers. There is, but only the Myerlocks can hear it. Oh, I've just got some lore for this place. So I'm guessing that thing keeps the Myerlocks away. Everyone was living happily. That thing got broke. The Myerlocks came on to the island. Everyone is now dead. Too bad for them. Okay. Well, gone! So I guess we just follow the yellow brick... wire? Follow the yellow brick road. Follow. Okay, it's going into the... very broken down ship. Okay. Is it wrong that that actually just scared me a little bit? Because it kind of did. Something tells me there's going to be Myerlocks. Or it's going to be really easy. Stay out of the water, it said. That does not look exactly that easy. Okay. Myerlocks. What the... Oh no, you are kidding me. Not a Myerloc queen. You know what? I'm running away. I'm activating that sodding thing, then I'm putting down a defense... weapon or something. Oh, wait, I haven't got the resources for that, have I? Unless this automatically goes to the other thing, which it shouldn't do. Oh, no, but it actually summons more of them. Unless they're just the same ones which have teleported here after fighting. Did it work? I can't see them. And he was definitely running away at the end. Well, the Myerlurk Queen's still there, but that may have actually worked. Fantastic if it did. Yeah! Long-range pistol. Oh, that does not no damage to you! Like, seriously! Oh, why do I not have the Fat Man right now? Well, I do- Oh no, I have one shot left! It's something! Well, we can't hit the shell of the thing, but that's okay. What's the most damaged? The torso. Okay, then let's aim at the torso. All the shots. Extreme minimal damage. Okay, let's run away. Where's it going? I mean, I'm okay with the pretty odd pathing here, but why are you doing this? Maybe the armor piercing would be better. Hello, can I please load the gun? Oh, come on, stop doing this bug! This needs to be fixed. I'm sorry, but right now I can't attack because my gun is apparently in my hand, but it totally isn't. Okay, how about if I quick save and load? Okay, we're back. Maybe it can't get near to that thing. Maybe it's just a matter of it can't get close to the tower at the moment. I mean, I'm okay if that's true. I mean, it makes a lot more sense than what was going on originally. Go away, little baby. I'm really not after you right now. Yeah, it actually seems to be doing quite well. Okay, well, let's just stick with this gun then for a while. Going to use up all the ammo in it, admittedly, but... easiest Myerlock Queen fight ever? It may just end up running away, which I'm actually okay with as well. I mean, I'd rather get the experience, particularly now it's on such low health, but... No, that's just not doing enough damage. Did I really just miss that? Die! Myerlock Queen, you can't hide when you've got a giant diamond above your head. Don't you understand this? Now burn while you're underwater. With all of our other weapons not doing too well, let's test out a brand new one, the Spryam Pry. Now, this was bought off a merchant who I think was called Cricket or something similar to that, and I haven't really tested it yet. It seems to do pretty well against very weak enemies, which I've actually had a chance to use it against, but I haven't had a chance to test it out against super mutants or anything larger. So I think the Queen here is the perfect test subject, especially since at the moment, she seems unable to fight back. Yeah, that damage definitely seems decent. Mowing through ammo, though. Actually, that seems more than decent. That seemed really good. Why was I not using this to begin with? Well, because I've never tested it before, but even so! Admittedly, I have upgraded this gun heavily since buying it. Everything's been upgraded, and the effect is just amazing, so I don't know why I'm surprised it did so well, but I'm still surprised that it did so well. Also, shooting this thing into the water is like the best thing ever, because you get the full explosion effect, which is just amazing. Okay, radioactive ocean. What's in the corpse? Good, good, decent-ish, decent-ish. Okay. Sadly, nothing special there. I am still on hard, aren't I, in terms of loot and such? Yep, definitely still on hard. Okay, well, with her dead, hopefully the workbench now actually works for us. Hello there, Myalurk Razorclaw, I can see you. Waiting in ambush does not work against Lathrix. Lathrix has a gun that shoots exploding bullets, therefore he knows all. Well, will you work now? It'd be lovely if you did. You do, fantastic. Okay, so the big problem, of course, is we probably don't have enough resources to do anything, because, of course, this place isn't hooked up to our main base at the moment. How about we quickly go over to the castle, and we see if we can make a quick supply link. Be really good if we could. Really hoping we can. Now that the castle is all hooked up to the island, and I've scrapped most of the stuff that simply needed to be scrapped, a load of metal, a load of radioactive barrels, and all sorts of other stuff, it's now time to sort out the major problems on the island. That is power, food, water, and defense. And let's start off with solving the water and power problems. And this time, we're going to go with the water purifier industrial, because these things are a little bit special. Not only will they generate 40 water each, which will be more than we'll ever need, since, well, we'll never have that many settlers, but they also very slowly add purified water to the workbenches, to the workshop, rather, and its inventory, basically meaning we can either sell the purified water or simply use it as health potions down the line. Either way, having some more things automatically being accrued is never a bad idea. And continuing that, we can sort out our power problem. With three added, it's time to add the final one. Okay, so let's put it over here and as close as possible about... Ooh, where can I actually put this? I was hoping a little bit closer than that, actually. Good enough. Okay, there we are. We have four of them, which means we can power both of these with a tiny bit of power to actually spare. Not bad at all. Now, the one thing I do want to stress is that these things, although they look fantastic, do provide very little power for the amount of resources, space, and even the size in terms of how much you can add to the settlement they actually require. So they're probably all we're going to add, maybe two more in the future, maybe, but for now that's pretty much that. So back to power, let's sort out the wiring first. So having them all wired up to one thing would be pretty good actually. But how about if we have a couple of power conduits? Okay, put them on the edge here. We can. Okay. Put one here. Then one there. U to U. U to U. I keep forgetting that the connection point on these is actually right at the base, not at the actual main body itself, which actually makes a lot of sense. It's just weird. Did I grab the wrong one then? I think I did somehow. Probably grabbed the wire by mistake. Oh no, it's saying I can connect to that. Never mind, I grabbed the right one. Excellent. So both of these should now have six power in each, which means all we need to do now is make some proper wiring at the bottom, which we can then run around the entire place in the future. not bad at all. So what do we have here in terms of our power usage? We have just regular power pylons, we have the large power pylons, which sadly do require some power. Essentially they're less efficient, which is really weird considering how small these are, but they do look a lot better. Perhaps at least for the first connection, then we can go into the small ones. And of course we can reposition all of this in the future. Right now I just want the very basics functioning so we can actually get the settlement online. After that we can work on having houses, having a main building for everything else, like crafting, and all the important stuff like that. I don't know why I'm putting it all the way around here, but I just am. I guess we could have the power conduits and all the cables going around the edge of the island. I mean, that makes complete sense, right? Attaching it to the power centers. The shoreline and the power centers attaching to each other. Probably not the best idea, really, considering water and stuff, but in my head it makes sense. That's the important thing there. And you connect to there, please. There we are. So we have 83 water. I think that's going to be enough. So right now we have power. We have a fence hitting me. We have power. We have basic water supply. So right now let's just build around here just for now so we can make sure we have everything basic going on. So for power, next thing then, we need the recruitment beacon, which will be here for now and I will replace later. Once again, I just want this place to start growing as soon as possible. So now it should start recruiting people. So all we need now is food. Do we have any mute fruit? We do, excellent, okay. This, on the other hand, we can build somewhere else. So where am I going to have the farmland in the end? I mean, this is a good place to start. I mean, it's already kind of suited for being a little mini farm patch, so this can be one of the farm patches. Especially considering we're using mute fruit, which is definitely the most efficient per plant. As I think all of the others give 0.5? Yeah, that's really weird, that is. I would like if some other plants would also give one so you can have a bit more variety, but mute fruit is fine. I mean, essentially, what we need to grow is all the different ingredients to make plant starch. Then that way we have infinite adhesive. There we are. We have mute fruit, we have water, we have power. What more can a person want other than a couple of beds? And I think I know where I could put those. Just for now, let's put a couple of beds inside here. Actually, no, that looks terrible. We could have it in here. I mean, this could be a little horrible bedroom. Yeah, there we are. The peasants can sleep here until I build something more fitting of members of the Lathraxian Legion. For now, they are mere settlers. And as soon as I deem them worthy to be Lathraxians, then of course I will upgrade their living quarters and everything will be better for them. Now that it's daytime, we can actually see what we're doing. I think it is only fair that we create a small housing area for these settlers that will soon call this place their home. As much as I do love the idea of them living in the power station, I don't think that's very fair, and honestly, it does take away a lot of the feel for the area. So for now, let's sort out this. So floors. What kind of floor do I want here? Oh, perhaps we should use a ceiling instead, or a roof. No, let's just use regular floors. Okay, that would make more sense, I know, since this isn't going to be the only floor. What do we have here, regular size-wise? Yeah, that looks better. Looks very standard. The question is, though, where are the stairs going to go? I'd say here, so let's destroy. Ooh. Oh, that's a problem. This isn't going to fit correctly, is it? No, it isn't. Because the stairwell is going to be one higher, so what I'll have to do is destroy this and put that in its place. Then we'll simply have to put a wall down underneath there to make it look a little bit more natural. And then continue walling up. Although, what if we had a bit of a internal balcony? So we have like a bit of a fence here so you can see down to the bottom level from this level. I mean, that'd be kind of cool, right? That's me thinking that. I mean, sure, it's me thinking that, but maybe that's actually correct. Can you please connect? Thank you. Ah, but then we'll have to flip the stairs around, which would be so really difficult. I mean, how am I possibly going to do this? There we are. And that looks down. We have it one higher. Then perhaps up here we can have something else. Wouldn't necessarily need the sleeping area. I mean, because we could still have this as a sleeping area. Actually, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Okay. So back to walls, then. Let's use the normal walls now. Wall off the outside. And then let's fence it up so that the bedding area on the top can look down. Ooh, why is that off? Why? Shouldn't have done that. Should have stored it instead. Why was that so much off? Oh, because it was attaching to the outside rather than... Oh, I see a problem there. It's going to leave a gap because we don't have the flooring extending all the way. That's the problem. That's actually quite a big problem. I have this there. This would work better if we had a bigger building to start off with. Is that worth it? Is it worth having that really painfully obvious gap? We could fix it by simply stacking them on top of each other, but then it would look wrong on this side. So we've got to address that in some way. After building the inside balcony in several ways, such as having only one side empty, having the middle section emptied, and all sorts of other combinations, I think it just simply doesn't work on such a small building. I think perhaps if we were to extend it one, or even better, two, then it would definitely work, but for now we'll just go with the simple option, keeping it as it is and sorting out a nice bedding arrangement. Look, they even get the nicer, comfier looking bed. That doesn't look absolutely completely filthy, only mildly completely filthy. And once these are all in place, just like at the castle, we'll sort out some storage containers in the room, things like footlockers at the end of the beds, and maybe some proper storage on this side. Or we could have proper storage on this side, but I think since you have such a huge middle gangway, that's not really necessary. A little bit regimented, but ultimately not too bad. And there's Curie testing out the stability of the wardrobe. Well done, Curie. Yeah, it does look a bit like a pseudo-army base in here, but it's nice nonetheless. At least I would rather be sleeping in here than in a power plant. And if we go upstairs, we have the viewing area, which is actually really pretty at the moment because the dawn's light is cascading through all of these lovely holes in the rooftop, so it at least gives it a very natural and wooded vibe, I suppose. Either way, it looks quite nice from the inside. The only problem is, from the outside, it looks a little bit featureless, and it looks a little bit impossible, as in the top section is just a little bit too big. It does look like it should be falling down, and I think I've got a solution for that in the way of using prefabs to fortify the corners, making it look like it's going back into the building itself, not just jutting out randomly at the very top. And with that, I'm afraid, though, I am all out of time for today's recording. I've just looked over at the clock, and I have been recording for far, far too long. Thank you so much for watching. If you have enjoyed today's episode, then of course, likes, favourite, shares, comments, all that good stuff helps out me, helps out the channel, and most importantly, shows that Fallout 4 is a series you wish to see continued in the future. Next time, we shall be continuing building up our island, and hopefully getting some settlers to actually work here. Soon, this will be the most productive money-making island in the entire Boston area, I suppose.